Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and in this video we are going to integrate Sonar Cube or Sonar Cloud with Azure DevOps CI pipeline for ASP.NET Core project. Sonar Cube or Sonar Cloud is a static code quality and security checks. It supports 24 different languages including Python, Java, C++, and many more. Let's create a project in Azure DevOps. I am going to keep this project public and create it. Project has been created. Let's upload the source code. I am getting import a repository. Source code is located on my GitHub account on this repository. Let's import the source code. My ASP.NET Core application code is ready. I am going to use the Sonar Cloud Market extension. Let's install the extension. Go to the organization and organization settings and click on extensions. Click on browse marketplace and search the Sonar Cloud. Click first one and click on get it free. This extension is already installed on my organization, so I don't need to install it again. This is the extension. Now let's create an account in Sonar Cloud. You can log in to Sonar Cloud with any of credential. I am going to log in with Azure DevOps. First create a organization. Organization and project should be minor of Azure DevOps. Sales department is a organization. Click on add additional info, give the name for display and continue. There are two plans, free plan and paid plan. If your project is a public, then you can use a free plan. If your project is a private, then you have to use paid plan. Since my project is a public project, so I selected free plan and create organization. All set. Organization is ready. Now you need to add project in this organization. Then click on new project. Then create a project key. This project key is going to represent your project. This project key should be unique across the Sonar Cloud. Go ahead and set up. It has been done. You can follow the guideline to integrate the Sonar Cloud with the Azure DevOps service. Let me walk you through all these steps in the real time. Go to the Azure DevOps, select the project and go to the project settings, then click on service connection, create a service connection and search Sonar Cloud. What we are going to do here, we are going to create a service connection for the Sonar Cloud so that this service connection can authenticate or authorize on Sonar Cloud. It is a required a सोनार क्लाउड टोकन टू जनरेट ए सोनार क्लाउड टोकन गो टू योर सोनार क्लाउड गो टू दी माई अकाउंट गो टू दी सिक्योरिटी एंड गिव दी टोकन नेम एंड जनरेट इट टोकन हैज बीन क्रिएटेड मेक श्योर दैट यू कॉपी दिस टोकन ऑन सेफ लोकेशन गो हैड एंड कॉपी गो टू द एजोर डेवॉप्स एंड पेस्ट हियर नाउ गो हैड एंड वेरीफाई वेरीफिकेशन हैज बीन कंप्लीटेड गिव द सिग्निफिकेंट नेम वेरीफाई एंड सेव Now we all set to create a build pipeline or CI pipeline for the .NET Core application. Then click on create pipeline. You can create a pipeline via YAML file or use a classic editor. For this demonstration, I am going to use a classic editor. Select a repository. Where is a source code? My source code is located on Azure. Git. Continue. Now select a template. Select this template .NET Core with Sonar Cloud. Go ahead and apply. The first step is going to restore NuGet package. In the second step, it is going to prepare your Sonar Cloud. Select the service endpoint or service connection. This is the service connection we created for the Sonar Cloud. Select the organization. The organization is coming from Sonar Cloud. Select the option for the analysis. I am going to integrate with MS Build. Provide the project key. Click on administration and click on project management. This is the key of your project. Give the project name. This is the project name. Leave the default project version. Leave other option as a default. Go to next task. In this task, we are going to build a .NET Core application. Leave the default value. And in this task, we are going to perform some tests on the application. In this task, actual Sonar code analysis is going to be performed and it is going to be start after build a project, leave the default value. In the final step, it is going to be publish a quality get result in the pipeline summary. That's all. In this pipeline, go ahead and save it. Go to the pipeline and you can see the pipeline is created. Let's go ahead and run it. build pipeline has been completed. To view the Sonar Cube or Sonar Cloud report, click on Extensions and you can see here Sonar Quality Gate Past. You can see a detailed Sonar Cloud report. This is the overview of Sonar Cloud report for the project. You can navigate on each tab to look at the detail information. It provided a very detailed information about your code quality and security. But overall, okay, this project passed the quality gate and qualified to promoting this application on continuous deployment pipeline. In this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.